Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you are doing well. First, let me welcome you to my channel. I hope you enjoy your time and get benefit from this lesson. Are you ready to start? Good, so let's go. It's my turn to read it, then I will ask you some questions, so please concentrate with me. Grandpa Lee is 80 years old. When he was a little boy, he had simple toys. He had bikes, wooden toy cars, puzzles, and lots of books to read. He played lots of board games. There was a park near his house. He played on the swings and slides. He climbed trees and ran around lots. His parents didn't have a car, so he walked or caught a bus to go places. They had a big vegetable patch in their back garden. They had fruit trees as well. Grandpa Lee's parents worked very hard. He helped them on the vegetable patch. So, this is our text. My question now. The writer of this text, is he talking about the past or the present? Think, please. Yes, correct. He is talking about the past. But, how did you know? علمتم أنه يتحدث عن الماضي. Think please. Read your text. Great, yes. Because he said when he was a little boy. Grandpa Lee now is 80 years old. But the writer is talking about his grandpa when he was just a little boy. Very good. So, when he was a little boy is what we call in English the time marker. What is a time marker? The time marker. It is any word or expression that indicates or tells the period of time we are in. Which period of time we are talking about? So this time marker shows us if we are talking about the present, the past, or the future. Now let's see the time markers of the past. First we have yesterday, bilans. Last week, last month, last summer. Usbu' al-madi, shahr al-madi, sayf al-madi. Ago, for example, you say 2 hours ago. 2 days ago, or 2 months ago. N plus a year in the past. For example, we are in 2020. So when you say in 2019, back to Grand Poly. As you told me, the writer is talking about the past. This means that the verbs in this text are in the past. So let's read them together. Was, had, played, climbed, run, walked, caught, worked, had. Good. Again, please. Was, had, played, climbed, run, walked, caught, worked, had. Very good. Now tell me, do you notice something about these verbs? What is it? Please, just look at them and try to tell me. There is a difference. There's something special. Excellent, yes. There are verbs which end with ed and others which don't have ed at the end. Activity and this table, we can see that when we put a verb or conjugate a verb in the past, sometimes we add ed and sometimes there is a change that happens to the verb itself. Yeah, it may seem question we ask now, how can we know? I will tell you. There is a list of irregular verbs, which, allow me to say, you must learn it by heart. When you learn it, or when you learn this list, the rest of verbs, ما تبقى من الأفعال, the rest of verbs are all regular verbs. Thanks again for trying. Just stop, please, now. And let's see the right order of the words. Sentence number one. We say, Anne celebrated her birthday yesterday. Why did we start with Emil? Emil in this sentence is the subject. And since we have affirmative sentence, we start with the subject. After the subject, we have the verb. What is the verb? Celebrated. Celebrated what? Celebrated her birthday. When? Yesterday. And full stop. And we follow the same steps with the other sentences. We look for the subject, then the verb, then our complement. And don't forget the full stop. Thank you. Now it's your turn. You have this homework. What is it? You are asked now to write two or three sentences using the past simple. But there is a remark, there is a condition. You need or you must use regular verbs with some sentences and irregular verbs with the others. Okay? So this is your homework, and you have enough time to do it, so please think about it.